All right. Well, this video is a little bit overdue. The last time I posted was like right before November 2nd, 2021, which was the election day. And I was a little disappointed. Win some, you lose some, though. What I was mostly disappointed at was despite some really important things going on in the in our country, in our cities and towns and all that kind of good stuff, sort of low voter turnout. That always concerns me because all elections count, all votes matter. And you can't bellyache and moan and all that kind of crap when you do not vote. So, I digress. I think in my pre-election post, I did say something about don't fall for the okie doke, which I do feel some of the people who did vote fell for the okie doke. But before I get into that, for real, I want to just serve notice that we've got work to do. We've got serious work to do. This coming November, what is it, November? I forgot what day election day is in 2022. That is the midterm election, though. And, of course, we always know that that's super important, but for so many reasons. It's going to be even more important than usual. And we need to start thinking about what our incumbents are doing now. And those who will be running for their respective seats again this coming in the coming 2022 election. And we need to register people, we need to familiarize ourselves with the issues, familiarize ourselves with the people who wish to be candidates for public office, and we need to think about some things going forward for the 2022 election, as well as for years going forward, and things we need to get rid of. We need to get rid of the filibuster. We need to get rid of the Electoral College. And we also need to get rid of the superdelegates. When it comes to primaries, superdelegates suck. And so does the Electoral College, and so does the filibuster. They served a purpose when they were when they came on the scene. However, they have outlived their usefulness, and as you can see, our democracy is in jeopardy. The games, the lies, and the BS is getting thick. It's getting thick. It's getting deep. You're gonna have to have on hip boots to wade through it, but you're gonna get through it. Yeah, we shall overcome. Real soon. Not someday. We're going to overcome real soon. But we got to do the work. We got to put in the work. And that's all I got to say about that. Now, What I meant by falling for the okie doke was that I'm speaking specifically or pacifically. I'm joking. I'm clowning or shading the people who, instead of pronouncing, well, their enunciation or pronunciation of the word specific, they say it's Pacific. So, so I'm gonna be Pacific, not Atlantic. Anyway, pardon my corny jokes, but anyway, the referendum in Richmond, Virginia, on the opening of a casino it already had passed that casino gambling was coming to Virginia, and there are already some casinos that are open. And we have lottery, and we have, I think we have horse racing or whatever in Virginia, and Richmond Durst came out in full force, and people protested before the election to say that they did not want the Urban One project to go forward. We did not want a casino in Richmond. So, the people have spoken. However, I don't really go for the reasoning that they gave for, you know, I don't believe it's all about not approving of games of chance or gambling or vice or whatever. Okay. I think it had a very lot to do with the project was being headed by and who the company that was going to be running the casino and resort was going to be Urban One. Urban One is under the parent company Media One, which owns TV One and Radio One, and this is a black-owned female. Female has controlling interest in this particular corporation that is building, which will be the first African American owned run casino in the United States. So I think that there's a little bit of a problem that certain people had for a woman to have so much power, and I don't think they like that. I think that had more to do with why they came out in droves to vote against this. A pop hits collage built from the 90s. So, I don't know. Maybe it's not. I hope it's not. But, what say you?
Good morning. You're on WOL in Washington, D.C.
What began as a small AM station in Washington, D.C. is now a media conglomerate. Action! Led by Alfred Liggins, Urban One has become the largest distributor of urban content in the country.
I think Alfred represents the highest pinnacle of what our industry is all about. He's a fabulous partner. He's a strong leader.
Urban One is unparalleled in its ability to deliver the very best entertainment across every media platform, reaching millions nationwide. That single DC station is now Radio One, a robust network of 63 stations throughout the United States, including Praise 104.7, Power 92.1, and Kiss 105.7. All right here in Richmond. And Urban One partners with Summit Media for added diversity in formats, reaching the broadest demographic from Southern to Soul, New Country to Hip Hop. The number one creator of digital content for millions of urban consumers is iOne Digital, with 7 bold, innovative digital platforms.
Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up.
Ricky Smiley, Erica Campbell, and DL Hughley are just some of the favorites on Reach Media, the number one urban radio programming syndication in the country. TV One is a premium network for African-American viewers.
Are you ready?
And Cleo TV is a lifestyle channel for millennials. TV One boasts a roster of over 55 original movies. And between TV One and Cleo TV, nearly 200 hours of original programming will be produced in 2021, including more movies, award-winning docuseries like Unsung, and star-studded award shows like Urban One Honors.
How everybody doing out there?
And get ready, because Urban One is bringing production to Richmond with an exciting new project that will create jobs and opportunities in entertainment and hospitality for the community. Because from the start, WOL's mission has been to serve and empower its community. And Urban One's community, Clothia, continues that tradition in Richmond.
We are so grateful for everything that you do and you mean to this community. Clothia, thank you and congratulations on behalf of Virginia.
No one is more committed to Richmond than Urban One's Radio Richmond. And with a winning combination of local presence and partnerships, premier leadership and star power, Urban One will create the destination for fun and excitement in the region.
Richmond unofficial election results from last night show that voters said no to building a casino on the city's south side. At 5, we heard from people who rallied for and against it. New at 6, our Brendan King spoke with the mayor one-on-one about those results. Brendan?
Yeah, that's right, Bill. And there are 5 cities in Virginia that have so far voted on a new casino. Richmond was the only city to vote no. And tonight, Mayor LeVar Stoney tells me that is a lost opportunity.
I'm voting against the casino because there's so many more options.
For months, we listened to the ads.
Southside wants this project.
We need it.
Opportunities like this don't come around every day. I said the same thing with Navy Hill.
Mayor LeVar Stoney fought to bring one casino and resort to Richmond.
Mostly disappointed for the number of people who will be missing out on good paying quality jobs.
He highlighted the obvious divide in the city as seen on this map.
I think that map was fascinating. We are still a divided community, not just by the river, but also by race as well.
Most in the north side voted no. Voters south of the river backed the project. And I asked Stoney if he thinks the vote was about race.
No, I don't think the vote was about race. I think when you look at the map, you see this is where our white residents live and this is where our black residents live. And our white residents, many voted no, and our black residents, many voted yes.
Stoney says the casino would have brought more than $500 million to the city over 10 years. That would expand opportunity, keep taxes low, and increase revenue.
I feel extremely proud of the city of Richmond.
The nonprofit Richmond for All ran a successful campaign against the casino.
Casinos are fundamentally an extractive industry. They're not reproductive. We know this isn't Apple computers. This isn't going to create products that stimulate the economy. Bring high wages.
Alfred Liggins, the CEO of Urban One, said in a statement he was extremely disappointed, writing, the casino would have served as a tourist attraction, providing financial resources to improve schools and roads. Liggins said last month if Richmond turned his proposal down, he'll try again elsewhere.
The folks who live in South Richmond overwhelmingly voted for this opportunity because they're the ones in desperate need of these sort of jobs. And now that door, unfortunately, is closed.
That nonprofit, Richmond for All, tells me that they pushed back on a major corporation moving into the city. But Mayor Stoney says that he needs to grow the tax base in our city instead of raising taxes and will continue to bring new economic opportunities to this area.
Last week, Richmonders voted against building a casino on the south side, but developers have said they wouldn't let that stop them. Tonight, we've learned where they've now set their sights. Our Brendan King is live to tell us how people are reacting to the news. Brendan?
That's right, Bill. If you drive about 20 minutes south of Richmond, down Interstate 95, and you will find Petersburg. Richmond voters rejected their casino, but this city wants in on the game.
I have a city here that's starving for economic development.
Samuel Parham serves as mayor of Petersburg, a city that could really use some good news right now.
We have a tremendous amount of needs here with our education. We need some new schools. We need some new infrastructure.
On Wednesday, Parham shared only with CBS6 his excitement over plans to bring a new casino and resort that Richmond voters rejected last week.
We've been blessed. For some reason, the word has gotten out, and we have several of the casino guys that was in Richmond down in Petersburg looking now.
Tuesday, scouts with Urban One toured the city searching for prime real estate off Interstate 95.
What is Richmond's loss can be Petersburg's gain.
State Senator Joe Morrissey says he jumped at the opportunity to help bring new jobs and millions of dollars to the families of Petersburg.
So I've asked that legislation be drafted by Legislative Services allowing Petersburg, Virginia to get one of the gaming licenses. After that's done, then it'll go to a referendum for the citizens of Petersburg.
Yet I spoke to voters who oppose a casino altogether, concerned about the gambling and possible violence.
It's going to deteriorate Petersburg.
Lynn Stanley worries if enough city resources exist in the event of emergency.
I don't think the infrastructure is there for a casino. I don't even know if it can support Petersburg.
For those people that say, well, I don't want a casino, we're already past that point. People are going to gamble.
I'm told reps from other casino companies have also reached out to the city interested in building here, while Senator Morrissey tells me that he believes voters on Election Day will support a casino.
Okay, guys, here we are with an Urban One update. So I'm just recording this video right as pre-market is opened, and things are not looking good. So right now, Urban One has absolutely been crushed. So there's a little bit of discrepancy in the election results. Okay, we're going to talk about that. As of right now, the casino has been the casino proposal has been rejected, but there still is hope. So I'm going to talk about a little bit about this in this video. Why right now? Okay, I didn't go obviously all in on this position. So I'm still want to probably hold until Friday. But like I said, a lot of people have ran for the exits, but me personally, I'm trying to stay optimistic with this. We're going to talk a little bit more about the proposal and get right into the bulk of the video, guys. Before I get into the video, guys, I want to be sure. So, guys, Webull is one of my favorite stock trading apps out there to trade stocks like Urban One. If you guys use the link in the description below, you get your two free stocks. One free stock when you open your brokerage account, your second free stock when you direct deposit. So let's get back into the video, guys. So as I mentioned in my previous video, I talked about the risk-reward ratio here, okay? Basically, we're waiting for the casino proposal to happen. If that had happened based on this stock's low float, it really would have went to the moon. But we had a little bit of issues here. So let's talk a little bit about exactly what happened. So here's an article. This article is posted on Virginia Business. It says, too close to call, but Richmond Casino appears unlikely. No votes lead by about 1,200 ballots, but Urban One says it will wait for final total. So the voting was done on Tuesday. They counted all the votes. And right now, the proposal has been rejected, which is ridiculous because the last four proposals for all casinos in Virginia were all accepted. So it's obviously very frustrating. This was a really, really exciting project. It was going to bring a lot of economic activity to the neighborhood. It was going to create a lot of jobs and just kind of provide a nice place for people to gamble and things like that. And it's quite in line with kind of the trend globally. Okay, gambling all over the world is up. All, you know, North America, Asia, Latin America, Africa, etc. So I was really expecting this to get passed. So let's talk a little bit about where that happened. So it says 51.4% of Richmond voters said no to the measure by a 1,200 vote margin, according to the Virginia Department of Elections unofficial results, compared to 48.56% who supported the referendum. So let's actually go to those results. So as you can see here, we're taking a look at the poll results. This is on NBC 12. As you can see here, the people that voted no just by about a few thousand votes, okay, not too many. So the problem is that there are some votes that are still going to trickle in, okay. So obviously, you know, the decision hasn't been made yet, but a lot of people are saying that it's going to be maybe unlikely. So I don't really know. You know, obviously a lot of people have sent in their votes. They haven't finished counting all of the votes, and all of the other casinos were accepted. But there's a lot of risk here, and I can see why a lot of people ran for the exit. Okay, you know, we're really on the fence here. So as you can see here, right now it's trading at around $6.79 after hours. So it was up as high as $12. $12.75 on yesterday's close after hours, and literally the stock has lost half its value in one day. But like I said, guys, you know, I'm not 100% sure what's going to happen. The voting decision is so close here. And also earnings is coming up, okay? Earnings is coming up on Thursday as well. So there's a couple of catalysts here. Even if the proposal doesn't get accepted, they do have a backup plan to try to build a casino in Central Virginia. But I'm not going to lie, really disappointed. Probably should have locked in some gains, and after hours trading got a little greedy, but that's part of the game, guys. You're going to win some, you're going to lose some. You know, if you guys have been following this channel over the past 2 years, we made good gains on AMC, we made good gains on Tesla stock, we made good gains on Lucid Motors. Like I said, I don't have a 100% success rate. I'm not gonna make great picks in every single one, and this pick is I still think there's something here, okay? So like I said, this company is so undervalued, and the enterprise value compared to the market cap is just ridiculous. And I think a lot of people ran for the exit. So I do think if you're thinking long term, if you're thinking that if the proposal gets rejected, they're going to have a backup plan, and you want to pick up some shares at $6, there's plenty of support here, okay? There's plenty of support at around $6.30. So we really haven't seen this stock trade below $6.30 since May 20th, when most of these tech stocks, EV stocks and things like that were really selling off. And then we had that big bullish movement. So, you know, I'm down a bit, but like I said, guys, you know, I never usually go all in or all in on these types of stocks. I just allocate a small portion of my portfolio. And like I said, if you're building a balanced portfolio, you're going to have some positions go up, some positions go down. But overall, over the long run, you should be going up. So now what I think is going to happen is I think that we're going to find out the official results on Friday. And there's going to be a lot of speculating here, okay? So we have the earnings call coming up on Thursday. Hopefully the company will post positive earnings. But right now, I'm really on the fence. I don't know. Now, there is a bit of upside potential here, okay? Let's say the last of those absentee ballots come in and the proposal does get accepted. Well, now you're looking at a stock that's $6 that now the risk reward is much higher, because literally if this proposal gets accepted, we could see Urban One stock go to, like I was saying earlier, maybe $20, $30, $40, because this casino is going to definitely take them over the $1 billion market cap. It is the type of catalyst that this company has really needed for a very long time. But like I said, right now, you know, things aren't looking 100% great. So like I said, do your own due diligence here. I'm going to update you guys, because I don't think we're going to know the official results probably until either at the end of today. So maybe at the end of Wednesday, Friday at the latest. I'll be sure to update you guys on what's going on. Be sure to follow me on Twitter as well. You guys can get the link in the description below. But it looks like there's a huge panic sell-off, and it looks like a lot of a lot of smart dip buyers have come in and picked up the share. So I don't think it's going to trade nearly as low below $6. I think there's going to be a lot of bargain hunters in there. So most likely we'll probably end up hovering probably between, I would say, $6 to $8 until we get an official word. If the proposal is 100% rejected, then we could see the last bag holders kind of just sell for a loss and move on. So like I said, guys, there is some risk here. I would say if you were just wanting a safer play that you thought like was guaranteed to go through, you could probably take a look at some of these other plays that are going on, like Bed Bath and Beyond. There's some other plays, you know, if you guys are looking to make quick gains in some of these stocks that are being heavily shorted and you think there's going to be a short squeeze. So like I said, guys, you know, a little disappointed that the proposal wasn't unanimously accepted. It's super close now, as I mentioned earlier, 51%, 49%. We'll see what happens to the last absentee ballots. I'm probably not going to panic sell right now, simply because if I was going to sell, it probably would have sold yesterday or even in pre-market. But like I said, I might even average down as well. I don't have so many shares of this stock, so I might just pick up some more shares, reduce my cost average. You know, the risk reward is there. If this stock runs, it could really provide 2-4x upside, and it's not going to plummet all the way to $1. So they also have a backup plan as well. So things aren't, you know, like I said, if they don't end up building it in Richmond, perhaps they can build it in Central Virginia or something else. But I do believe that this casino will eventually get built within the next few years. So for you guys out there, that are, especially you younger guys out there, if you're looking to hold this long term, I think if you hold Urban One throughout this decade, I think you're going to be pretty satisfied with your gains. And like I said, you don't have to go all in on this. You can just allocate maybe a small percentage of your portfolio or whatever your risk tolerance is, guys. So like I said, I'll give you guys an update when I get more information. But right now, so far, it looks like the proposal will not get accepted. But we're not 100% sure, so I'll let you guys know. So just follow me on Twitter. I'll give you guys some more updates. So if you guys enjoy my video, please smash the red subscribe button. Hit the like button as well, because it's good for the algorithm. That's all I got. Until next time, guys. Take care.
Okay, all right, again, this is Big Bella, and now that you have seen it all, well, not at all, but you know, however much I'm, what do you think? I think that, I'm just really glad that, just because Richmonders did not want it. Petersburg is probably going to benefit from the project if they come out and vote for it. And I think they need it even more than we do, as far as they probably but I go back to, I really, really, really think that they had a problem with black woman headed company having that much clout and power, and you know, don't have a problem with, you know, our Caucasian brothers and sisters benefiting from the fact that we like to gamble, and you know, would be, you know, terrible and totally, you know, you know, being a man trying to keep a Native American sister or brother down if they, you know, came out and protested against a Native American after after coming over here and stealing their land and then telling them that they can't develop what they need to develop to in order to help their communities. Well, I'm not getting into that, because that'll be a whole nother post that I'm going to get into. But I really think it was some old systemic racism BS was the reason why Richmond rejected it. I don't think it had anything to do with, oh, there's going to be more crime, there's going to be too much traffic, there's going to be, you know, whatever. A whole lot of other crap that does not need to be here is here. But if it's going to make money, and it's going to make money for certain less diverse group of the population, it's going to benefit them, then that's fine. It's going to benefit certain minority groups. It's a problem. It is a problem. It's like, oh, you know, they're taking over. It's like, whatever. Really. But anyway, I just say, people, do not cut off your nose despite any part of your body. Okay? Because Richmond needed that money. They needed that revenue. But now Petersburg is getting it, and I'm glad. What say you?